Hello, Chef.
Flavor also.
So now we can cut this a little bit, and we can prepare also the pickled water.
Pickled water?
The water is still hot, so they can be slightly cooked in the water, because they're all very crunchy. You can see the beautiful colors of our vegetables. Okay. Same with the purple. And I put the meat for so long before the trying the same ingredients, all the time, the same food, and I think that's what keeps it exciting and interesting.
Yes, trying out different
ingredients. The vegetable go in there, and then I can put it on the side.
Ah, you're parboiling it, is it?
Yeah, just because they're all root vegetables, so they a little bit cooking is okay for even for people.
Hard-boiling?
Not exactly hard-boiling, because you take it off directly, so, but it's anyone. We have the chefs already, so we can learn just by working in restaurants. And I think in Indonesia there's many many chefs also that they're not trained or didn't learn at some training.
Yeah.
And culinary school gives you only some basics.
Yeah.
But you don't learn cooking in the school, you just get the basics and you get some knowledge.
Yes.
But then you need to develop that, otherwise you will never be a good chef.
Yeah.
So it's your experience, working in different places and learning, never stop learning, that makes you a good chef.
Yay, that's from Chef Gil, everyone. Experience makes you better.
Regular pesto, you can put also pine nuts or things like that, but today we don't need a anything else than the timber flavor.
But actually, Chef, maybe after today, people will come and ask you to give me the try.
Yes. Yeah. And you can put a little bit more.
Yeah. That looks amazing.
Yeah. 10, 15, 20 minutes maximum. And then we can grill it.
Yeah. Actually, for the smell, the coriander seeds do it for me.
Yes,
I mean,
it's a really nice flavor. Yeah, when you toast them like that,
yeah.
Very nice.
Smells amazing. I like
that.
Yeah. It's a nice touch.
It's not
100%
traditional thing, what we're doing today, so we can. Originally it came from a Chinese pork marinade.
Oh, really?
That's how it goes.
Yay!
Some pesto, potato puree, some pickled organic vegetables.
Yay!
Ready for tasting!
Ready for tasting! Let's do it! Let's take a photo first, shall we?
Photo. This.
Okay.
If you have a tenderloin, of course if you have a piece of beef that's not so tender, you might need longer, and then you will get more tender.
Yeah, okay. This is perfect, guys. This is perfect. And you can try it at home, right? This is
easy. Easy, you know?
Yeah.
Everybody knows how to make a marinade. The rest is all simple, mashed potato, a bit of kimchi pesto. Vegetables, I think very simple, and maybe a way to impress some of your friends.
Maybe you can start impressing some of your friends with some Indonesian flavor next time. Okay, that's amazing. Thank you guys for joining us. We hope to see you again. We hope to be in your kitchen again sometime.
Anytime, we can cook some more Indonesian flavors using some local products anytime.
Yeah, from home Indonesia, definitely. Oh, wow. No, see, you made me 2 promises during life now. Okay, so, before we go, thank you, Chef Kanipe. Okay, thank you, everyone. And we'll see you guys soon. Yeah,
bye.
Make sure to check out Amis Gourmet as well. Okay, bye, guys.